Okay, let's talk about Mayon volcano now. We're seeing alert level 2 over the area. What's the situation like out there in Albay?
Well, we've been experiencing and detecting rockfall since this year. Mm. But since April, there has been a slight rise in the incidence of rockfall. And then in this past few days, since June, we've seen a rapid, steep increase in the incidence of rockfall events. No? Mm-hmm. Now, rockfall in Mayon is actually quite significant because this means that material is being pushed beneath the neck of the volcano. Mm-hmm. And so the material is being pushed from beneath, so the material on top of the dome is actually collapsing and forming rockfall.
Okay.
So we might see this as the start of another magmatic eruption,
okay.
But there is also the possibility that this might cease. You know? So there are two scenarios: the 2018 scenario, in which rockfall activity progressed into magmatic eruption, mm-hmm. or the 2014 scenario, in which the rockfall activity progressed into a very short lava flow and then stop. You know, so we can have these two kinds of scenarios.
So it's interesting because Mayon volcano is very much well observed, considering that it is an active volcano. Based on the symptoms, on the signs that you're seeing right now, how immediate can an escalation happen given those conditions?
Well, the big difference right now is we do not see a very high emission of sulfur dioxide. Mayon is a notorious emitter of sulfur dioxide, and in most of its eruptions, there is a very pronounced increase in the sulfur dioxide
emission. Which we don't see at this point.
So we are not really expecting a rapid escalation of activity. But then again, it can happen.
Yeah.
Volcanoes. We can have a sudden influx of magma from beneath, and the rise can be rapid. So it's really difficult to say. We really need to observe the volcano 24/7.
Okay, we know that Albay is used to volcanic eruptions, given that Mayon is very active. But still, even if there are protocols in place, what is the advice to residents there?
I think people already know that they should stay away from the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. Okay. Because of the danger of rock falls, landslides, and if we have a sudden phreatic eruption, we might have pyroclastic density currents, or what the Bicolanos call uson,
right,
rushing down the slopes, and this might affect them. You know? So within the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone, there should already be no entry or minimization of activity within that zone.
Okay, Mariton Bornas, we appreciate the information to keep us posted. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you, and ingat po kayo.
Have a good day.